Well, this is Catherine. Welcome to WOKidney. There is a lot of dangerous misinformation about the renal diet out there. So today, I'll show you why you should eat more bananas, mangoes, and even oatmeal to repair your kidneys. And I'm not even kidding, alright? These foods are full of healthy antioxidants, fiber, and vitamins. They can even lower your blood pressure. But as you may already know, in order to avoid high potassium and phosphorus levels, kidney disease patients are told by their doctors to completely avoid healthy fruits such as banana, mango, orange, and even many healthy whole grains such as oatmeal and quinoa. This will not only make your life harder, it may also make it harder to improve your kidney health. And I'm not the only one thinking it this way. There is science to prove what I'm saying. I'll show you in a moment. Because saying that bananas are not bad for a kidney patient may seem a strong statement. I know, but I'll show you why I'm convinced potassium in fruit is not the potassium you should be worried about. And I'll also show you how to use this info at your advantage to repair your kidneys. Because, you know, when I see patients starting to take care of themselves, advocating for their health and eating in an informed way, I'm always positive that they're going to get the best outcome possible. And let's see why I'm telling you this. There are three things that can cause your potassium levels to rise at the point of causing symptoms. This is called hyperkalemia, a dangerous condition caused by too much potassium. Things that can cause it are dietary factors, high potassium foods, additives and salt substitutes, inability of the kidneys to filter excess potassium, prescription drugs such as ACE inhibitors, but also beta blockers, ARBs, and more. But what's really causing an imbalance in your potassium levels is just one of these things in most of the cases. It's prescription drugs. They call it drug-induced hyperkalemia, and it is considered the most important cause of high potassium in everyday clinical practice. So the first two things can contribute to hyperkalemia, but the prescription drugs are what's causing the problem, okay? And this is important because nephrologists and dietitians always tell their patients to watch out for potassium in what they eat. But how many doctors educate their patients about the bigger dangers posed by these drugs? Because these drugs are well known to cause high potassium levels, since they make it harder for the kidneys to remove potassium. And there are several studies telling us exactly that pills are going to create the greatest dangers for hyperkalemia or high blood potassium levels. Because a wide range of drugs can induce hyperkalemia, but the main culprits are angiotensin-converting enzyme, ACE inhibitors, and angiotensin receptor blockers, ARBs. And maybe your doctor told you that you need to avoid potassium in your diet if you want your heart to keep beating. What he should have told you instead is, I'm giving you pills that will mess your blood potassium levels up. But hey, if you die, it's not my fault. It's that half banana you've eaten 3 weeks ago. Okay, this may be not funny, but overprescribing, it's not funny either. So, what medications I'm talking about exactly? Blood pressure drugs called angiotensin receptor blockers, ARBs. ARB medications including losartan, telmisartan, valsartan, and irbesartan are the most likely medication to raise your potassium levels. Blood pressure drugs called ACE inhibitors. These are blood pressure medications ending in "-il", like lisinopril, enalapril, and quinapril, and also beta blockers such as sertraline, tenormin. All these medications are used to treat high blood pressure, very common in kidney disease patients, but can cause your kidneys to retain potassium, okay? So, these three classes of drugs are the main responsible for high blood potassium levels in kidney patients. Not bananas, okay? And a disclaimer, but this is very important since I'm talking about medications. I know you may be tempted to just stop taking these pills if you're taking them. Don't do it. It's really dangerous to stop taking any medicine on your own, especially if we're talking about medications for your heart. Discuss all medicines that you take with your doctor. But in any case, there is already something very interesting to learn here. If you don't take these medications, chances are that you can already have all the bananas, spinach, mangoes, and avocados you want, or at least with some portion control. Now you may ask, how is this supposed to help me improving my kidney health? Because yes, maybe learning new things about how the kidneys work can be interesting, but if you are here, it's because you want to improve your kidney health, right? So, what's to learn from this? First of all, your diet is not responsible for your potassium levels. And in addition to impairing nutrition status and quality of life, advising patients to limit or avoid many plant-based foods, especially fruit and vegetables, may contribute to metabolic problems. Conditions like a higher oxidative stress on the organs, inflammation, swelling, metabolic acidosis, and higher blood cholesterol are all associated with a diet poor in these potassium-rich fruits. Limited potassium intake can also cause your blood pressure to rise. What I'm basically saying is that it's true that you can repair your kidneys eating more bananas. Now, before starting to add potassium-rich foods to your diet, get tested for potassium levels and consult your doctor. If you want to know more about how to understand blood potassium levels and what foods are rich in potassium, watch this video up here. But there is another point to make here. If you are actually taking one or more of these medications that are messing up your potassium levels, don't worry, not everything is lost. You can still find ways to reduce your need for these medications if you can lower your blood pressure in other ways. A better diet and lifestyle changes can greatly help you. I've talked more in depth about this in this video up here. And if nothing else works, there are still two options left. If you have to take ARBs or ACE inhibitors, get prescribed one with hydrochlorothiazide, HCTZ, like for example lisinopril, HCTZ, and valsartan, HCTZ. These kinds of combo pills have one medication that raises potassium levels and another that lowers it, ultimately resulting in normalized potassium levels. Some people may also need special medicine to help remove extra potassium from the body and keep it from coming back. These are called potassium binders and often come in the form of a powder. They are mixed with a small amount of water and taken with food. When swallowed, they bind to the extra potassium in the bowels and remove it, just like phosphorus binders. Bottom line, don't ignore your potassium levels. Make sure you are having it monitored, especially if you take any of the medications I've mentioned earlier, and also avoid potassium-based salt substitutes and potassium dietary supplements. But don't obsess over potassium levels in vegetables and fruit. Patients have to eat this way for life, so totally avoiding healthy fruits is not always the best choice. So talk to your dietitian and find a way to include more healthy fruits and vegetables to make your renal diet more variegated. It's for the health of your kidneys. And if you want to know more about the smart way of repairing kidney damage with potassium, I've made a video just about this. It's up here. But don't go away yet. We've addressed bananas and mangoes, all right? But what about oatmeal? Is oatmeal healthy too? Yes, it is. Now, the other thing I wanted to talk about today is phosphorus in whole grains like rolled oats. There is really a lot of misinformation about this topic, and I mean a lot. I always tell people to eat more whole grains. And I say it again, eat more oats, buckwheat, quinoa, barley, bulgur, and so on. Whole grains should be the cornerstone of your diet. Now, when I talk about this in my videos, I have two options. I either have to make a large preamble telling people why whole grains are not unhealthy for kidney disease patients, or I have to face dozens of comments telling me that I'm giving people bad advice, like in my video about the 5 healthiest superfoods. Here are some of the comments I received. Oatmeal is too rich in phosphorus. Eating oatmeal is not good. Oats are high in phosphorus. How it can be a healthy diet? And this one is very funny. It says, I feel like oatmeal just punishes my kidneys. It's funny because it's not on one of my videos, it's on the VIDA's website. Yes, dietitians from the VIDA recommend people with kidney disease to eat oatmeal too, and they get the same reactions I get. So, let's make things clear here, because it's absolutely true that phosphorus is not good for you if you have kidney disease. Normal working kidneys can remove extra phosphorus in your blood, but when you have chronic kidney disease, your kidneys cannot remove it. And getting too much phosphorus from the diet can cause damage to your body and your kidneys. So it's absolutely true that you should avoid high phosphorus foods such as dairy and many packaged foods if you have kidney disease. And it's also true that the whole grains I've mentioned earlier contain phosphorus. But still, this shouldn't stop you from eating oats and other whole grains. And this is because your body is not going to absorb all the phosphorus in whole grains and other plant-based foods, okay? There are various studies proving that the ratio between protein and phosphate in foods is what really matters to the quantity of phosphorus your body can absorb. What this means is that you should disregard the phosphorus in whole grains, especially if they are unprocessed, since you are not going to absorb it. Your body is just going to get rid of it after you eat. Now, the researchers are even able to tell us how much phosphorus you are going to get from different foods. This is from a peer-reviewed article published on the journal Blood Purification, a very reliable source. Phosphate bioavailability varies between foodstuff. In whole grains and nuts, it is 20-50%, okay? This is what percentage of the phosphorus in these foods you're going to absorb. In dairy, seafood, meat, and eggs, it is 40-60%. And in processed foods, sodas, cheese spread, it is 90-100%. So you're going to get just 20-50% of the phosphorus from whole grains, all right? Let's see what does this mean practically. Let's see an example. Here. What we have here, a cup of rolled oats, a cup of milk, and a cup of cheese spread. Let's keep in mind that the daily allowance of phosphorus for kidney patients is around 800 milligrams. Now, if you eat a cup of cheese spread, which I don't recommend by the way, it contains 200 milligrams of phosphorus. And you're going to absorb almost all of it because it comes from additives mainly. and 200 milligrams of phosphorus is a lot, okay? All foods have some phosphorus, so it's not wise to have this much from a single food item. Now, milk is a little bit better, but you are still getting 120 milligrams of phosphorus from a single cup. But what if you eat a cup of rolled oats? On the paper, this contains 180 milligrams of phosphorus, alright? But your body is only going to get 63 milligrams of phosphorus. So, why should anyone want to remove oatmeal from their diet? It's beyond my comprehension. Now, if we take a look at this slide, about some high phosphorus foods, I divided them in three categories. Bottom one is food you have to avoid. Okay, it's phosphorus from additives or preservatives. So avoid fast foods, ready-to-eat foods, canned and bottled drinks, enhanced meat, and most processed foods. Phosphorus from food additives is completely absorbed. Phosphorus additives, called phosphates, are found on the list of ingredients on the nutrition facts label. Look for to find phosphorus additives in the food. In the middle, we can see some dairy, and these foods should be limited, okay? You can have some cheese once in a while, but avoid processed dairy. In the top category, we have beans, nuts, grains, and cereals. These foods contain the phosphorus you won't absorb, but only if they are not processed, all right? So in conclusion, you can eat oats and many more whole grains if they are not processed and they do not contain additives. And I hope this can be helpful to improve your diet and your quality of life, because there are several things you can do to improve your kidney health, but none of this involves removing healthy foods from your diet. Because working with kidney patients, there is one thing that I've noticed. They have a lot, and I mean a lot, of troubles finding things they can actually eat. I mean, most dietitians give patients infinite lists of things they cannot eat. And while removing salt, sugar, and processed foods is always a good idea, removing plant foods is not. So, I hope this video will help you eating better for your kidneys. And by the way, if you want to know more about what foods are safe and healthy for our renal diet, I've made a video for you. This is all for today. I hope you enjoyed this video and God bless you. See you next Friday.